In this video, we'll study about the pectoral region. The superficial fascia of the pectoral region is fibrofatty and it encloses the mammary gland. The platysma muscle, it occupies the upper part of the pectoral region and it sweeps upward and forward superficial to the clavicle towards the neck after taking origin from the underlying pectoral fascia. The deep fascia of the pectoral region is known as the pectoral fascia. This fascia is attached to the clavicle and the sternum and it innervates the pectoralis major muscle, and at the floor of the axilla it is thickened to form the axillary fascia, and then it splits and encloses the latissimus dorsi muscle. The hollow of the armpit is formed by the axillary fascia, and the hollow is maintained by the attachment of the suspensory ligament of the axilla to its summit. Next, we'll study about the pectoralis major muscle. It is a thick triangular muscle. It is broad at its sternoclavicular origin and narrow at its insertion to the humerus. It forms the anterior wall of the axilla. The upper border of the muscle is separated from the anterior border of the deltoid by a small triangle. So this is known as the infraclavicular triangle. Infraclavicular triangle. So the upper border of the pectoralis major muscle is separated from the anterior border of the deltoid muscle by a small triangle that is known as the deltopectoral triangle or infraclavicular triangle. And the lower rounded twisted border, so this is the lower rounded twisted border, it forms the anterior fold of the axilla. Next, we'll see the origin of the pectoralis major muscle. First, we'll study about the clavicular head. So, the clavicular head arises from the medial half of the anterior surface of the clavicle. Next is the sternocostal head. Whichever highlighted in the purple is the sternocostal head. So, it arises from the lateral part of the anterior surface of the sternum up to the 6th costal cartilage. It also arises from the 2nd to 6th costal cartilages, and it arises from the aponeurosis of the external oblique over the upper attachment of the rectus abdominis muscle. Insertion, the muscle converges to form a flat bilaminar tendon about 5 cm broad, and it is inserted to the lateral lip of the intertubercular sulcus or bicipital groove of the humerus in a U-shaped manner, at the lower border of which the both lamina are continuous. So this is a diagrammatic representation of the pectoralis major muscle origin and the insertion. So this is the origin. So this is the clavicular head, which takes origin from the anterior surface of the medial half of the clavicle, and this is the sternal head, which takes origin from the lateral part of the anterior surface of the sternum up to the 6th costal cartilage, and it takes origin from the 2nd to 6th costal cartilages and also from the aponeurosis of the external oblique over the upper attachment of the rectus abdominis muscle. And this is the insertion, and the muscle converges to form a bilaminar tendon, and it is inserted to the lateral lip of the bicipital group or the intertubercular sulcus. So here you have two lamina. One is the anterior lamina, the other one is the posterior lamina. The anterior lamina is thick and it consists of superficial, intermediate and deep fibers. The clavicular head forms the superficial fibers. The manubrial fibers forms the intermediate fibers and those arises from the sternal margin and the fifth costal cartilage, they form the deep fibers. The posterior lamina is contributed by the rest of the sternocostal fibers and the fibers from the external oblique. So these fibers join the posterior lamina in a twisted manner so that the fibers are lowest at the origin become highest at the insertion. The costal fibers, however, do not twist. The upper limit of the posterior lamina is higher than the anterior lamina and it reaches the capsule of the shoulder joint. Nerve supply. The pectoralis major is supplied by medial and the lateral pectoral nerves. The medial pectoral nerve reaches the pectoralis major muscle after piercing the pectoralis minor. The lateral pectoral nerve reaches the muscle by piercing the clavipectoral fascia. Next is the action. Acting as a whole, the muscle produces a medial rotation of the shoulder joint. So here you can see the medial rotation of the shoulder joint. So this is the medial rotation. Acting as a whole, the muscle produces adduction of the shoulder joint. So this is the abduction. So this is the adduction. So the muscle acts on the shoulder joint producing adduction of the shoulder joint. The clavicular head produces flexion of the shoulder joint as in pushing. So this is the flexion as in pushing. The sternocostal head helps in the extension to bring the flexed humerus to the side as in climbing. When the humerus is fixed in abduction, the pectoralis major muscle acts as an accessory muscle of inspiration.